This is an unboxing of Nemesis, the retail version. So I think this is a 2 to 5 player game. And it essentially is supposed to be, I mean, aliens without being aliens. And I think it is probably the best rendition of aliens. It does have this hidden, or the potentially hidden trader mechanism, but you don't have to play with it. If you like this video, please like and please subscribe, and please take a look at our other videos. So it is a fairly complex game. It's done by Adam Kapinski. I think his games tend to be kind of rules heavy, but there is a video to learn how to play, which is good. Room sheet to go over rooms, which is important. The artwork in this game, I think, is pretty good. These rooms look pretty good in terms of the tiles, and it gives some uniqueness to the game, the fact that you can change the rooms up. Shower room, airlock control. And I think the expansions have new rooms. I know there's a second version of this, which is a base on Mars, Lockdown, which may be even better than this game. I think this is a good game. I think it needs the right group of people. And I don't know how well the hidden trader mechanism works. It is always a little bit scary, you know, which direction they chose to go if you play with the hidden trader. So these are different characters, which the artwork looks pretty good. You have your typical captain, scientist, pilot, etc., all with different abilities. I do think, I forget which one I played, but the ones that attack are pretty helpful. So I don't know what this is, this Nemesis box that you can unfold. I'm never a big fan of those things. And then we have our board, which I'm not going to unfold the whole thing, but we'll take a look at the miniatures in here, which is really one of the best things since it's Awakened Realms. So it's a good looking board. It is it two-sided, if I remember right? Yeah, there's two sides to this board. I forget if it's for different player counts or what. So in here, it's a multi-level insert, so we'll do each level separately. Don't eat the gel. So in here we have some cool miniatures for aliens, and actually a pretty well done inserts. And then we have our different heroes, so which are also well done. I mean, I think if I was a better painter, I would really like to paint these and actually have them turn out good. You even have like the scientist in the, or the, I think it's scientist or engineer in the wheelchair who's not very, and you have the soldier with the extra, I think I may be like out of aliens or Starship Trooper or something. We have a scanner for checking infections, which is kind of, I think, a very interesting mechanic, because you can go down the thing of getting infection tokens, but you don't know if it's going to kill you until you get to the end. We have a bag, which is a high quality bag. We have some dice for rolling combat. We have, oh, this is cool. Even in the retail version, we have little gears, and we have these little tokens. We have little aliens, and we have big aliens. So I forget which one this is. This is like the bigger alien. And it is neat that the bigger aliens look cooler. Even the base game has these awesome translucent tokens. That is a really nice touch. We have, let's see what else. I guess nothing else really in there. I'll come back to this in a minute. I'll take these out. And then we have a second insert, which is kind of hard to take out of here. So I'm not going to empty this insert, but we're going to take a look at some of these minis. I don't think I'm going to go through the cards. I think the cards are just normal stuff. In a kind of adventure-ish game. It does have a spot to put all of the tokens and empty space for future cards, so that or for sleeved cards. That's really a good touch. If you want to sleeve the cards in here, they have room for it. So this is like, I think, the queen alien who looks awesome. It's like, I don't know, throwing or eating little aliens at you. And it's a huge miniature, you can see. I'm impressed that it survives the travel without breaking. We have like medium, or I guess big big aliens. There's three of those, or two of those. And we have slightly smaller aliens who look... I mean, all these things just look... These miniatures look amazing in this game. I think playing this, you would almost feel like you're in Aliens. And they are quite delicate miniatures. And we have, like, a little bit smaller alien. Looks pretty good. And that is really cool. It is a cool-looking game. It is amazing that they put these inserts in it. So I'm going to pull out the cards and just give you an idea of what the cards look like. I don't want to go through all these because they're not super interesting. They're just going to be typical cards with infection cards, with your cards you're drawing for encounters to see if you made noise and you woke up the aliens. Objective cards for the traitor mechanism, which I think is, as far as like hidden traitor, you're not forced to be a traitor. You choose to be a traitor in this game. And you get to choose after a period of time. I think it's when the first alien shows up, you decide. And vulnerabilities and stuff. And then you also have bandages and weapons. And it's not an easy game for sure. I do think probably the traitor mechanism makes it a little bit harder because someone may be working a little bit against you. So there you have it. That is everything that comes in Nemesis retail edition. If you like this video, please like and please subscribe, and please take a look at our other videos. Thank you.